This chapter is about internal trade, so we are going to learn about wholesalers, retailers, what are the types of retailers, what is the role of CII in internal trade in India, and few performer invoices and similar kind of documents which are used when we do internal trade. To begin with, no country in the world can say that I am self-sufficient, I really do not need to buy goods. Every country specializes in certain goods, and for certain goods it depends on some other countries. Okay, so on a geographical basis, trade has been divided into two scenarios. That is, first, the international trade, which is when a country trades with another country. Internal trade. Now, internal trade is when the trade happens within the country. So that is, there are not two countries involved, but then between the people of the same country, the trade is happening. So that is known as internal trade. Now, what is the need of internal trade? The need arises because we have different states, or we have different geographical location within the country itself, and everyone would demand certain type of goods. For example, Punjab is famous for production of wheat, but then it's not like only Punjab who would eat wheat, it would be people down south who would require wheat to eat. So this production, that is the production of wheat, once it is done, it has to be transported and sent to the south so that people can buy and consume it, and that is the reason you would require internal trade. Okay, now let's understand the meaning of internal trade. Internal trade is nothing but buying and selling of goods and services with the objectives of earning profit. Let's say, like I gave you example of Punjab sending wheat to down south, so the producers who are sitting in Punjab, they cannot go ahead and do all the activities, that is, produce the goods, produce the wheat which is required, then market the wheat, then even sell it to the consumer. There has to be some people in between the entire cycle who can help the producer in getting the goods being transported and ensuring that they reach the final consumer. See, we cannot ignore the importance of trade in modern times. It has increased as new products are being developed every day and they are made available for consumption throughout the world. Okay, as I was explaining you earlier, no country is self-sufficient, and also now because of technological developments, what happens is, if some product is developed by XYZ country, then the demand can happen in the entire world. Similarly, within the country, it might happen that some particular area may develop a product which would have demand in the entire country, and hence you require trade for movement of goods from one place to another. Now, let's see what is the classification of trade. See, we have the wholesale trade and retail trade. So when it comes to internal trade, there is a wholesale trade and there is a retail trade. Now, both of these are different. How they help in internal trade, let's understand that. See, the manufacturers, that is, let's assume the wheat producers, will approach the wholesalers. So the wholesalers would buy from these manufacturers. The manufacturers would then sell these goods to retailers. Now, what is the difference between wholesaler and retailer? See, wholesalers would always buy bulk quantity. So in terms of wheat, they would be buying tons of wheat from the producers. But when it comes to retailers, they would be buying in kgs. Okay, so it would be, let's say, like if 100 kgs was bought, if the requirement of retailer can be as low as 100 kgs. So when it comes to wholesaler and retailer, the difference is they are directly purchasing on a wholesale basis from the manufacturer, and then they distribute this to retailers in small quantities, and then these retailers finally sell to the ultimate consumer, that is the person who is going to consume the goods. Now, when it comes to retail traders, the wholesalers would sell the goods to retailers. So the retailers would be buying from the wholesalers, and the retailers would then be selling it to consumers. So difference here is that the retailers are not involved with any deal or transaction with the manufacturer itself.